So earlier in the week, Rishi Sunak, the UK's Chancellor, announced the new budget, highlighting where the government will be spending in the coming months. At the very end of the video we made about it, we mentioned the impact that Brexit is already having on the economy. That's because as much as the government might not like discussing Brexit anymore, the UK's ongoing withdrawal is having big impacts on the economy. So in this video, we're going to examine the findings of the Office of Budget Responsibility and look at how Brexit was subtly mentioned in the budget documents. Before we do though, a quick shout out to our merch store. We've got new badges, magnets, t-shirts, hoodies, mugs and stickers live on the TLDR store, and the first 10 people to use the code RISHI will get 10% off their order. Find the link to the store down below. So first let's take a look at the Economic and Fiscal Report, which was published by the Office of Budget Responsibility. This report looks into a variety of things, but does mention the economic impacts of Brexit, and concludes that the UK economy is 2% smaller than it would have been without Brexit. Paragraph 1.12 goes into more detail on this, and says, "We estimate that the economic effects of the referendum vote have so far reduced potential output by around 2%, relative to what would have happened in its absence. Part of this reflects lower net inward migration, but mostly it reflects the weaker productivity growth on the back of depressed business investment, and the diversion of resources from production towards preparing for potential Brexit outcomes. Real business investment has barely grown since the referendum, whereas our March 2016 forecast assumed that it would have risen by more than 20% by now. We expected this shortfall to be partly reversed as the specifics of the trading relationship were clarified, hence reducing uncertainty. But working in the other direction, we expect the adverse effect of higher trade barriers to build through our 5-year forecast period and beyond. Broadly speaking, we believe that around 1/3 of the long-term hit to productivity from Brexit has already happened, that another 1/3 is likely to come over the forecast period, and the rest comes beyond our forecast horizon." So, let's take a look at box 2.1, which goes deeper in something the report just mentioned, how business investment has been impacted by Brexit. Chart A here shows 4 different forecasts, one from March 2016, another from November 2016, one from November 2017, and one from today. What's clear is in the months since the initial projections, the reality has been a lot harsher than was expected. The report explains this, saying that the initial projections assumed that the UK would leave at the end of March 2019. However, with that date repeatedly pushed back and the transition extending to the end of 2020, uncertainty has been stretched out longer than was anticipated. The report remarks that business investment has been weaker than we expected immediately after the referendum. Recent productivity growth may have also been dampened by a diversion of resources away from productive activities to prepare for Brexit, especially the possibility of no deal. The document also sheds light on the expected benefits of Brexit. One of the core promises of the Leave campaign was that there'll be huge savings after leaving the EU, savings which could then be spent on the NHS. So, when you look at Table 1.3 of the document, you can see exactly how large those savings are projected to be. In 2020-21, it's expected that Brexit fiscal savings will only total £4.3 billion, equivalent to £82 million per week, clearly far less than the buses promised. This is set to go up, however, until 2024-25, when the savings are projected to equal £14.6 billion, or £280 million per week, getting closer to the advertised figure. However, a lot of that money is just replacing the EU funding that the UK got before leaving. The report isn't telling the most positive story, which guarantees that some will label it as pure project fear. What's interesting, though, is as it plays out, the reality of the situation becomes clearer, and it becomes easier to quantify the true costs of Brexit. So what do you think of these findings? Are you worried that the economy is being negatively impacted by the UK leaving the EU? Or do you think that once the UK's out, the benefits will begin to materialise? Let us know your thoughts in the comments below. Also, be sure to subscribe to the channel so we can update you on this as it plays out, and hit the bell icon to be notified every time we release a video. You can find more from TLDR News across all social networks simply by searching for TLDR News. And a special thanks to our Patreon backers who make videos like this one possible.